Hey everybody, this is Devin with HDPiano.com, and in today's lesson we're going to check out Stone Cold by Demi Lovato. We're going to learn the verse in this video, but if you want to continue on and learn the rest of the song, then the rest of the videos can all be found over at HDPiano.com. So here's what we're doing today. 1, 2, 3, 2, 2, 3. Slows down a bit and then resumes. So that is the verse, and that's going to happen again later on in the song. But I will also be showing you guys some of the string parts that we can play over the second verse to kind of spice up the piano part a little bit. All right, so before we dive in, I've got a question for you guys. This song is in 3-4, and I'm just curious. It's kind of unusual for a pop song, especially for like an angsty ballad like this. You know, pretty common to you know, most songs are just in 4-4. So I'm curious, what is your guys' favorite song in 3-4? Or can you name another great song in the 3-4 time signature as opposed to 4-4? All right, comment below with your ideas, and let's get started. So in the key of F minor, at least the verse is very dark, but once we get to the chorus in the next video, you'll find that it starts strong on A-flat major, and that's because F minor and A-flat major are relative. So F minor is the relative major of A flat. They share a lot of the same notes. It's just a matter of, you know, where you put the emphasis that defines whether it sounds major or minor. So it's F or A flat. So in the verse, we're going between D flat major, then we take it up to F minor, then we do another D flat, and then we take it to A flat. And so you'll notice since A flat is the fourth chord, it's only just kind of like a hint at major. You know, we're mostly, you know, we're going D-flat to F-minor, so we get kind of a dark sound, and we're just hinting at the major. But then once we get to the chorus, boom, we hit the major on the downbeat, which means it's, you know, suddenly feels bright, which is kind of interesting considering the subject of this song. Anyways, that's your little theory nugget. Let's get started. D-flat in the left hand, two octaves below middle C, which is here, and D-flat, F, and A-flat in the right hand. This is a D-flat major triad in root position. Now we just take that shape up to F minor. F in the left, F, A-flat, C in the right. All right, so that was D-flat major to F minor. Now the left hand's gonna go back down, but the right hand's gonna move up to second inversion. A-flat, D-flat, and F. All right, so it's the same notes, but in a different order. D-flat major still. And then we get to our A-flat major root position. So A-flat in the left, A-flat, C, E-flat in the right. So first three measures, let's do them in tempo. 1, 2, 3, nice and slow. 1, 2, 3, 2, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 2, 2, 3. Even a little bit slower, I realized I was kind of not that slow. 1, 2, 3, here we go. 2, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. All right, great. That's our first four. Moving on. Same chords, but we've got some new voicings. So we've got D-flat again in this position. A-flat, D-flat, F in the right. We're going to take that shape, that second inversion shape, and move it up to F minor. So again, the same notes as F minor when we played it down here, just in a different order. C, F, and A flat. So D flat major to F minor. And here we have E flat major. That's E flat in the left, B flat, E flat, G in the right. And we play quarter notes for two measures. 1, 2, 3, 2, 2, 3. Okay, there you have it. So we've got our first eight measures. Now this pattern is going to repeat three times. So we've done one, we've got two more to go. We start again on D flat, and then we do the same. We move it up to F minor. We go back to D flat, And we go to our A flat root position. All right, so notice this segment didn't start really low with root position. It started with second inversion. All right, then it comes back to second inversion, D flat, up to second inversion, F minor. And then again, we have our two measures of E flat quarter notes. Now in this particular measure, she kind of slows it down and we hold that out until we get into the next one. But let's recap real quick. We've got through 16 measures. So root position D flat is how we start. One, two, three, here we go. Up to second inversion D flat. Root position A flat, second inversion D flat, F minor, E flat for two measures, second inversion D flat to F minor, back down to D flat, A flat, D flat, F minor, and E flat major for two bars again. All right, so we've only got 8 measures left. And they're not very different. We start with D flat major again, second inversion, and we bring it up to F minor, second inversion, back down, and then to A flat. So those first 4 measures are the same, and the rest is the same. D flat major up to F minor, second inversion, and E flat for 2 measures. And then, boom, we land strong on the chorus, which I'll be showing you guys how to play in the next video. So I'll go ahead and play you guys out with a recap of the verse, and I hope to see you over at hdpiano.com, because that's where you're going to find the chorus, the second verse with the string parts, and everything else in the song, including a performance of the entire song. So here we go. 1, 2, 3, 2, 2, 3. Slow it down. Pick it up. And then we're into the chorus. All right. So we'll see you guys over at hdpiano.com for the rest of the videos. But while I have you here, if you could please like and subscribe here on YouTube, that would be much appreciated. And go ahead and follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, HD Piano on all of those platforms. And we'll see you over at the site. This is Devin with hdpiano.com. Thank you so much for watching.